in the landscape. If you look up, the ceiling will be above there, and they are 20 meters, so the rest of it is below you. This bridge in the dike was the worst in the whole area. There were many bridges in the dikes. When you take a walk through the museum, you will see a map that indicates the total area of this disaster that happened in 1953. The worst part, the worst bridge in the dike, was also the last to be repaired. A small bridge would be easy. You would get bags and fill them with sand, put it in the bridge in the dike, and that would be the end. But this bridge, being so large, took 9 months to repair. So if you were lucky, between brackets, and your house was still standing after 9 months, you were one of the few, because many houses had collapsed already. But your house would have stood the waves and would have withstood the water, but the tide would have come in twice a day. So your house would be flooded twice a day. So you can't repair anything as long as the water is still there. But people who were not so lucky, many houses had collapsed during the flood, but many houses also collapsed later because the tide would go out a little and people would think, well, you're still here and the house is still standing, we'll just stay here. But the tide came back again, and if your attic floor, which is made of wood, had been in the water, it would have come off the brick wall of your house. And with the water going down, it would not have been very stable, so if it went up again with the next time, the walls would collapse, or your wooden floor would simply drift away in the waves, in the storm. So many houses collapsed later, and this island, there was such a large area underwater that this island was not noticed. It was not noticed that it had been almost completely covered in water. It happened in the night of the Saturday to the Sunday, at 2 o'clock in this island, 3 o'clock sometimes, but it had happened the evening before in Great Britain. But there was no alarm system between Great Britain and the Netherlands. And also, if there had been warning in the evening, after 11 o'clock, no more telephone, because the lady who switched your telephone calls you was not there anymore. This is 1953, not your time that you're in now. Also, the radio stopped broadcasting at 11 o'clock in the evening. Television, very few people had a television. The church bells would ring whenever there was someone who opened the door to the church. Not always the case, some people were not at home. But if there's a church bell ringing in the middle of the storm, who would hear this church bell? So people were unaware of the catastrophe that was going to happen that night at 2 or 3. So most of them were asleep, and some would be woken up by a noise or by people shouting to find themselves surrounded in water, in the dark, no light, because electricity had gone down, not knowing where to go, not seeing the road anymore, so where do you go? It's only dangerous to go out at night in the dark, not knowing where your road will be. So they stayed, most of them stayed, if they could, in the house. And some floated away on beams, on parts of a roof, parts of a floor. There was a couple living nearby. There was a father and two sons. The father and the two sons drifted across the water. If you are on the dike here, this is quite a large stretch of water. And they were found on the dike, on the other island. The father could still speak. Well, one of the boys was in a coma, did not speak, but he survived. And the second boy was dead. And that was the first time that people on the other island thought there must be something very wrong over there. But it took until the Monday for a helicopter pilot to fly over, who could not find the island. He reported that there was something very wrong. And the Monday afternoon, people from the army sent over a boat where the ferry is at the tip of the island near the east of the Netherlands. And they went back because it was getting dark, but they reported that there was a large area flooded. We did not know how large. There was only 10% of this island that was above water. That is the part near the beach, in the west, near the North Sea. raised steps and the rest was dry. But you will see later in the film, I will raise my finger when I see that street. I'm going to show you documentaries that were made for the television when they broadcasted. And otherwise, these were shown in the cinema. Every Saturday you would have another film and they would have another newsreel. Some of them have been assembled and we're going to show them to you. So it will have photographs of films, film footage of the time of 1953. In these days, whenever there is a flood anywhere or a tsunami, you have film, you have, this is put on video, you have much more. Most of this was taken after the flood had already subsided. The flood lasted, the severe storm, I should say, lasted for 2.5 days approximately, which is unusual. That is one of the reasons that flood happened. I'm going to ask you, after you've seen this newsreel, what the causes of the flood have been. You know one already, the length of the storm. I'm going to switch it on now.